How do you learn the Cleveland market if you're a California investor, right? How do you learn the Cleveland market? Well, I'll tell you. You learn it by watching this show. I'm guessing that's why you clicked on it. Because I haven't uploaded it as I speak to you, but I'm guessing I probably set the title up as How Do You Learn the Cleveland Market as a California Investor, something like that, right? So that's going to be the question we're going to answer. If it wasn't, that would fucking suck, wouldn't it? This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS, and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Welcome to the show, folks. My name is James Wise. This is HoltonWise TV. If you're in California, you want to learn about Cleveland real estate, woo boy, subscribe. Also, if you're in New York or like Texas or Cleveland or wherever, man, you're trying to learn about Cleveland real estate, you are in the right spot. You're trying to learn about real estate in general. I also believe you're in the right spot, right? You could take a lot of what I teach you here on this show, apply it to any market. But if you want to go further and partner with my team and get true on the ground, boots on the ground resources, Cleveland's where you got to be. And today I'm working with my dude, Adam, California investor. And I know, Adam, you're really trying to learn the market, right? You're sending me deals. I'm sending you deals. And we're learning together. We're doing deals. We recently closed one in Cleveland. And I got a deal for you today. It's a duplex, and I really, really like it. And I felt it was important that I get this to you because, you know, you've made it very clear to me that you're utilizing my services for deal flow and things of that nature. But you really want to learn the market. And that's cool, man. Like, hey, what I'm teaching you, you're paying me to do, right? But the kind of idea, right, is eventually, like, you'll extract a bunch of knowledge, and you probably won't need me forever, right? I'm like training wheels, folks. Use me while you got me, but eventually you'll be able to take them off and know what you're doing, right? At least that's my goal, right? I mean, don't get me wrong, Adam. If you want to, you know, keep sending money my way for the rest of my life, that'd be cool. But, like, I'm really hoping to provide you the value and teach you some things, right? And today, I think just based on the numbers, you're going to really love this deal, and I think you're going to want to buy it. But I'm going to be spending a lot of time talking to you about this neighborhood and the value I see there, because from you in California, thousands of miles away, I bet you none of what I'm about to teach you and talk to you about this little area is getting to you, right? People talk about Cleveland, 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 but there's a lot more going on than just the word Cleveland. So, Adam, I want to get into that right after this.
Two, please.
I think it's too big.
No, I think it'll shrink in the lot.
Welcome back. Let's jump into the deal. I love this deal quite a bit, okay? 210 14th Street, Elyria, 44035. Been on the market 7 days, priced at $89,000. Now, I love Elyria, dude. Oh, my God, do I love Elyria, right? Here's the cool thing about Elyria. This is why I really love it. On a national stage, people are like, looking at the Cleveland market, right? Investors all over the place. Like, there's always articles or this or that about Cleveland's a great cash flow market. If you want to get cash flow properties, Cleveland, Cleveland, Cleveland. It pops up everywhere, right? You know, you do something like, what are the best cash flow markets in the United States? Cleveland's always in the top 10, right? Sometimes it's even listed as number one on a lot of those publications, right? What's cool about all that is that it's Cleveland, Cleveland, Cleveland. It beats into everybody out there's head that all the Cleveland area is the city of Cleveland. Not the case, right? The city of Cleveland's got like 350,000 people in there, right? The greater area, several million, okay? So there's a lot of suburbs in and around that area that are not getting a lot of attention. Elyria is one of them. I think it's a nice little sleepy suburb. It's like 40 minutes west of the city of Cleveland. And for those of you that are looking for some type of comparison here, right, where LeBron is from, Akron, right? Everybody says, LeBron's from Cleveland, LeBron's from Cleveland, LeBron's from Cleveland. LeBron's not from Cleveland, LeBron's from Akron. That's south of Cleveland, about the same distance, right? So it's in the general area, right? We service Elyria. We have tons of properties in Elyria, right? But it's off the radar, which is great because it allows us, in my opinion, to pick up deals we couldn't have otherwise got if they were in Cleveland. This property would not have remained on the market for 7 days if it was in Cleveland, folks. $89,000. This thing's awesome. It's a side-by-side duplex. Side-by-side duplexes are, in fact, the best friggin' duplexes. Now, it's fully occupied with long-term tenants, so do not expect this thing to be, like, spick and span, beautiful, looking fresh, looking clean. The real estate agent for the seller only provided one photo because, guys, it's really friggin' tough to go through tenants' houses and take pictures. They don't, like, want to deal with all you fucking assholes, like, interrupting their life. But it don't really matter. Some people think that's a red flag. It's not. There ain't nothing special you're going to see in there, folks. I'm going to tell you this right now. I already know what it looks like. It looks like it needs a turnover when these tenants move out. They're long-term tenants, folks. You do not get to buy $90,000 duplexes in the Cleveland market with long-term tenants, and then when they move out, you just sweep it up and it's ready to rent for the next tenant. That don't fucking happen. If that's your expectation, it's wrong. You're gonna need to refresh the unit. Paint! If they got carpet, we're replacing it. I like to replace it with vinyl or hardwood so you mitigate that cost in the future. You don't have to deal with that again, right? We may need to do Home Depot, Lowe's quality kitchen cabinets, bath fixtures, right? So we might be looking at like $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 per unit when these folks eventually move out, right? These folks have been there for quite a long time, and it already cash flows where they're at, $750 and $600. But market rent, since it's side-by-side, which is the premium layout, folks, that's $800 a unit, $1,600 a month, or $19,200 a year, right? They have it listed at $89. We need to pay $89, okay? I assume there's eventually going to be multiple offers on this. Yes, it's still on the market today because it's got an Elyria address as opposed to a Cleveland address, and it's getting less national traction. But look, a lot of people understand this is going to make money because this thing's a fucking cash cow. So be prepared to pay $89 or more, right? $1,600 long-term market rents. After you run your fixed and variable expense estimates with Holton Wise handling everything on the ground for you, you're looking at an NOI of about $709 for the month on average, $85 for the year on average. Some years will be better, some will be worse, right? As you see, we got capital expenditures. I'm saving up $960 every year for you, right? That's for things like roofs, furnaces, hot water tanks, none of which are anticipated to be new. This is not a scenario where we get on our contract for like $90,000 and then we get the inspection report back and you're like, oh my God, the roof is like 20 years old. How much is a roof? And I go, oh, well, this roof would probably be like $7,000 to replace. You go, oh my God, ask the seller for $7,000 off. No, motherfucker, it's not. No, look. This house is worth every bit of $89 or more in its current condition with long-term tenants paying below market rent, with units that are dated, and there is no expectation of there being a new roof, a new furnace, or a new hot water tank. I factored that type of stuff into your analysis here, folks. Capital expenditures, right? $960 a year. You don't do a roof every year, obviously. You do a roof once every 30 years. Costs about $7,000. Hot water tanks. You're usually going to be replacing those bad boys every 15 years. Cost about a G right now. Furnaces. Cost about 3 Gs. You're usually doing those about every 3 years. None of these mechanicals are brand new, folks. They're all currently working. Why would the seller replace them? If you got a furnace, it's probably going to work for another 5 years. Why the fuck would you replace it? You wouldn't, right? So the property's going to be worth that. Those are the proper expectations. The thing's still going to kick off a ton of money, right? Who's to say we actually have to kick these tenants out to get them up to market? If we slowly get them up to market, right, slowly bring them up, we wouldn't have to have a turnover, and then we'd be looking at a friggin' 23.1% cash-on-cash return, right? Only $22,250 out of your pocket. This is a solid investment. As far as Elyria goes as compared to Cleveland, I've already mentioned that nationally people aren't paying attention to it enough. In my opinion, Elyria, it's like a high C. Maybe I might even consider it like a B neighborhood, dude. I believe personally that the tenant base in Elyria is a little more easygoing to work with. I feel like we're doing better with our Elyria tenant base than a lot of the West Side neighborhoods in Cleveland we deal with, right? Crime appears to be lower, and like I just feel like overall we're doing very well. Like if you give me you know, the Cleveland, West Side of Cleveland, Elyria, I enjoy investing in both of them. But right now, I believe Elyria is probably the better play that a lot of people don't know about. Additionally, the government, much easier to deal with, right? Like, this is a Cleveland market, folks. There's a lot of different cities out here, right? Cleveland, East Cleveland, Cleveland Heights, right? A lot of people think those three are the same. They're not. That's three completely different cities. Then we got Elyria, we got Luray, we got Lakewood, Rocky River, Garfield Heights, Bedford Heights, Newburgh Heights, Parma Heights, Parma, Brook Park, right? All these areas in the greater Cleveland area, every single one of them has a different government, different rules, different procedures, right? That's why you hire Holton Wise, because we can navigate all that. But what I'm telling you right now is I am really big on Elyria. And the other thing, too, didn't stress this enough, I'm really big on the fact that this is a side-by-side duplex. A, you get more rent, but B, what you do is, and it's more important than the additional rent. Like, if this is an up-down, I would say the market rent's about $750, right? We squeeze an extra 50 bones because it's the up-down layout or the side-by-side layout versus the up-down layout. We squeeze out an extra 50 bones per unit there, right? But that $100 a month, $1,200 a year, that's not what I love about it. What I love about it is it reduces turnover. You get long-term tenants, right? Because it's not as much sound annoyance, right? Nobody's above you. Nobody's below you, right? That kind of stuff causes tenants to fight. When tenants fight, they become unhappy. When they're unhappy, guess what? One of them usually moves out, right? So that becomes a problem. And the majority of duplexes in the entire Cleveland market, all the cities I just mentioned, most of them, I would say like 95% are built with the up-down layout. So whenever you get the opportunity to pick up a side-by-side property, absolutely do it. So in my opinion, there's no such thing as a can't-lose deal, but this is very much as close to that as I think you can possibly get in the Cleveland market. For your money right now, this duplex is a friggin' banger. Let me know what you want to do.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to HoltonWise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.